You have a smartphone, don't you? I'm sure you've had this trouble if you have a smartphone. Have you typed something and struggled to go back to that right word where you're trying to correct that and you're trying it with your finger and it there's an awesome way to solve that. Android or iPhone. So on your Android phone, you'll need to install the Google keyboard in order to use this. It's called the Gboard. Just go to the Play Store and install it. And then that's pretty much it. Some of you guys asked me about my mustache. So what I do first is, just kidding. So once you've installed that, go into your phone and go ahead and type something. This is my text. Let's say you want to change it to this is my text to this is your text. So ideally, you would use your finger and try to point to the place where it says my, but then it's not at the end, so you try again. But now it's doing something else. To solve this problem, use the space bar on your phone. This little guy, use him. It's not going to autofocus because the autofocus is on my face. You see how sharp that is? It's really sharp. Anyway, this space bar, you use it like a trackpad, like you use it on a mouse, you know? So set your finger on that space bar and move it left, right. Don't hold it for 3 seconds. Don't hold it for too long. Tap and move. And you'll see that almost as if magic, it moves to the left and the right. And you can go exactly where you want and get rid of the text and write what you want it to write. When I start using this move feature, you know, at first it's like so fast and then I have to slow it down and come back. That's kind of, I hope they fix that. Is that a bug? Instead of using your finger or using that magnifying glass, which is really finicky at times, this thing works like a charm. If you went to the settings part of the app, you'll actually discover so much. Let me show you something else. Let's say you're at the end of your text, okay? And you want to get rid of more than one word. Let's say you have 20 words. So if you want to delete back, like you did on the space bar, now start on the delete button. So if you press the delete button and moved, it starts selecting the text. And you can choose how much of it you want to delete. Like, just look at that. That's so awesome. You can choose how much of it you want to delete. And if you just let go, it deletes it. Another something that you can do is if you have a character in the character part, you have to hit that character button and look for exclamation point or whatever. So instead of doing that, if you just did the same thing from the space bar and from the delete button, but this time start from the character button, you know, you drop it on the exclamation mark and now it has placed it. You don't have to press it, use it and come back, you know. So as I said before, just spend some time on the settings part of this app. Go to your system settings and look for language and input. And under keyboard, hit Gboard and here are all your preferences. Spend some time over here and you can actually do a lot, you know. If you guys remember the dark theme video I made a couple of weeks ago, you can have a dark keyboard that's really black and green or whatever accent color you choose. You can have that if you have an AMOLED screen. This works really well. Instead of having a white blue which just hits your eye in the dark, you know, I like to have the dark theme. It saves battery. It goes with my phone's dark theme and it's just awesome. I even got this number line because it makes it so much easier to type with that. My friend has an iPhone actually. So we are actually going to his house. He just lives not too far away from here. And I'll show you guys that you can actually do the same thing on the iPhone as well. So on the iPhone side, nothing really changes so much. If you press and hold the space bar and move, it's just like we saw on the Gboard a short while ago. But you can also go up and down and stuff. So instead of doing this and finding your spot, you can also do this and find your spot. Or if you want, you can even install Gboard. And then do the same thing from before. That's it for this video, guys. I hope that was helpful. Take care of yourselves and I'll see you next week. Bye-bye.